Hello, my name is Árpád Figyelmesi, and I am the product manager of Chemoxon Markush Editor application. Today, I would like to show you how to use this application for small molecule chemical patent drafting. Usually, the drafting process starts with a set of compounds coming from your customer or your research group. I would like to show you two examples, first a very simple one, and later a more complex real-life example. I will show you how to start from the set of compounds and generate your Markush draft. Let's imagine the situation where a very simple set of compounds is your starting point. As you can see, we have four benzene rings here with methyl and ethyl substituents in one position and different halogen substituents in the other position. The drafting process in this case is quite trivial, but easy to follow and good for this demonstration. The first step is identification of the scaffold. In Markush Editor, this is completely automatic. Choose the Markush Composer function, just select the sampler file that I previously showed, and it can be an SDF file or a ChemDraw file. Most of the standard chemical file formats are supported for import, but you can also use a list of IUPAC names. Just click on Finish. As you can see, the application immediately generates the corresponding Markush structure. The generated Markush structure not only covers the original input structure, but also all possible structural combinations of them. As you can see, the library size is 8 compounds. If you select any of the examples, the tool highlights the corresponding part of the Markush structure and shows how it matches to your example structure. If you would like to test any further structure against the Markush, you can easily edit or read it from a file. I just added some very simple compound containing a hydroxyl group in this position. As you can see, it is not matched here because the hydroxyl group is not covered by the generated Markush. The tool highlights the non-matching hydroxyl group and also highlights the corresponding part of the Markush structure. You can fix easily by adding the hydroxy group to your definition, and now it matches with the compound. In the editor, you can also do different kind of generalizations. For instance, in this case, we can replace the methyl and ethyl groups here with an alkyl homology definition. And define it as a 1-2-3 atom alkyl group by just editing the homology properties. As you can see, it is still matching to your compounds because these are still covered by the modified Markush. The editor is quite simple and easy to use for editing your Markush and generalization. However, at the end of the day, you would want to see a draft in the text format. Markush Editor contains a feature called Markush to Text that can generate the claim draft automatically. You need to enter the name of it. Here I just named test, but I already have a file with this name, so just overwrite it. As you can see, a very simple Markush draft is generated. Obviously, this is not a legally compliant text, just a draft that you can use as a starting point. So, in general, the use of Markush Editor is this simple. As I mentioned in the beginning, I would like to also show you a more complex, more real-life example. I prepared a larger set of compounds coming from a patent document. It contains 67 compounds. These are more drug-like, and from this point it is not so trivial anymore how to generate a Markush structure from this compound list. As you can see, these are nice big structures, and as I mentioned, we have 67 of them. Basically, you can do the same as previously. Use these compounds as a starting point in the composer process. Select the corresponding SDF file and do the Markush creation. As you can see, the Markush generation is very fast. It was less than 2 seconds and you have your complete Markush. This Markush is more complex compared to the previous one. It has multiple levels, as you can see, and it has also a quite large library size. We started from 67 compounds, but now it covers more than 33,000 with all of the structural combinations. You still have the interactive editor, so during the generalization, you get immediate feedback after any modification. For instance, if I delete any of the fragment definitions, the tool immediately tells me that now only 64 of the 67 definitions are matching, so this compound is not matching anymore. So I undo my modification, now it works fine. Let's do the text generation next. Just choose the Markush to text. As you can see, the Markush claim is generated and we have a quite long list of R group definitions. We use multiple different export methods here, so some of the fragment definitions are represented as an image, some of them are generated in the form of linear notation or IUPAC group name. So these are the basics of Markush Editor application and how to use it for patent drafting. The Chemaxon team is happy to answer any questions if you have. Thank you for watching.